welcome to the Aviva Stadium. We're here for the SPAR FAI Primary School 5's National Finals 2019. It's been a record year with 1,696 schools from across Ireland battling it out for the top 24 team places here. As you can hear, we've already had kickoff, but let's find out a little bit more about today's event.
There are six titles up for grabs, three for girls, three nominally for boys. The girls are allowed to compete in these as well. Four teams in each group representing each provincial champion, and it's a round robin basis, meaning everybody has a fair shot at the title.
I'm here at the Aviva Stadium now with our international stars, Megan Campbell and Keith Andrews. Guys, great to have you here with us this morning. Megan, it's a phenomenal day today, great atmosphere, and obviously a huge increase in female participation.
Yeah, definitely. There's stats saying that there's a 121% increase in women's since the start of the tournament with SPAR in Ireland. So obviously it's a massive increase in female participation, and hopefully it continues to rise.
Megan, you were telling us a little earlier, you've never had the chance to actually play in the Aviva Stadium. It must be an amazing opportunity for the students and the kids to get to play today.
Yeah, definitely. I wasn't lucky or fortunate enough to play in the Aviva yet. Hopefully someday that will come with the national team. But obviously it's a great opportunity for the kids to experience something on such a big stage, and to come out with their friends and families and to just enjoy the day, basically playing football in Ireland's home football.
And we've got two amazing influencers here, yourself and Keith. Tell us, what's the state of play been like so far?
It's been brilliant. We've been walking around, taking some of the games in, and just to touch on what Megan said there, the fact that they get the chance and opportunity to play on the hollow turf, it must be so exciting for them. We've been speaking to some of the kids before they've kicked the ball, and they just can't wait to get out there.
Now, this competition has gone on quite a few years, so I guess for you guys watching 4th, 5th and 6th class coming up through the ranks, you've seen the same kids coming back each year and actually their skills developing each year. That must be, you know, really, really exciting to see.
Yeah, very much so. It was a team just down there from Wexford, and some of them same as last year. They've come back second year in a row, and the coach was very excited. He was also very confident as well about how far they could go, wasn't he? So they've won their first game, so they should be a threat in this competition.
Well, we'll be checking out our future stars on the pitch today. Back later.
Skull No Shoon to Colum Kill of Donegal kicking off against Trefrask of Cork and falling behind immediately. Jack Crowley wide awake, good finish. Quick thinking also, and a quick throw from Trefrask keeper Liam Crowley. Tom O'Connor mopping up the chance to clinch a 2-0 win for the team from the Berra Peninsula. Clonliss National School in blue from Berrin County Offaly with early pressure on Ard Kieran of Sligo and a thumping finish coming from Fionn Carney to give them the lead. Clonliss 1-0 up at half-time, this to kick off for the second half, Niall Kenny tying it up. From Fionn Carney's throw, Robert Carney showing great tenacity to drill home and give Clonliss the lead again. And you've seen this before, same player, same result, 2-2. This would very much be the Niall Kenny show. Dad Johnny was second highest scorer in Sligo Rovers treble winning side of 1994. Going on to score against Club Bruges in Europe the following season. A well-timed interception opening the door to complete his second half hat-trick. No matter what the angle, always worth a try. That was fourth. And this completing a remarkable 5-goal haul. Niall Kenny providing all of our Kieran's goals in a 5-2 win. The two sides who had lost in the opening round of group games facing off in round two. Fionn Carney's throw parried by Colm Kill keeper Dylan McGlynn. Liam O'Riordan scoring the only goal of the first half. What an effective tactic those Fionn Carney's throws are, finding Robert Carney to make it two. O'Riordan stuck in the corner with no support. So what then? He found the answer. His second. Clonliss third. Fionn Carney with two assists and then a goal of his own. Clonliss well on the way to victory. The Leinster champions having their resounding win, rounded off by an awkward but effective Killian Curtis volley. Cullum Kill finding the net themselves through Sawyer Campbell. A meeting of the two sides who'd won their opening games and who had met in last year's competition, with the Sligo side taking the lead this time, Darren McKeown from long range. A bolt from the blue from Tom O'Connor, drawing Trafrask level. Into the second half, and Kieran hadn't learned. O'Connor with another belting strike. Niall Kenny couldn't have targeted his speculative attempt any better. A trademark of his, 2-2 late on. And Kieran pushing for the winner, but stretched from their own corner. O'Connor darting away, setting up Jack Crowley for the deciding goal. Trafrask nick it again.
Hi guys, and welcome to the Aviva Stadium. Your first time here today.
It is indeed, Sharon, yeah. We're having a great time.
Tell us the school you're representing.
We're representing Scallagh and Killian, Ballinafinion, Fantown, Donegal.
So it's fantastic to see some great Scallagh as well being represented here today. That must be super exciting.
Oh, it's great. Great atmosphere about, you know, it's brilliant. Just
That's perfect, Tom. That's a great excuse for your song. Now, Paddy, you and the school have written a song. Do you want to give us a go?
We'll give it a wee. We're singing it now.
Going into the final round of group games, Con Kill were the only team unable to lift the SPAR A Cup, but our Kieran still could. Troy Kelly having a couple of attempts early on, denied by keeper and post. Kelly's next option to tee up Darren McKeown instead of having a go himself. He chose wisely. And Kieran rampant early on. Niall Kenny continuing his great tournament with a brilliant goal. More Troy Kelly generosity would supply McKeown with another 3-0 to Ard Kieran. Cullum Kill still with pride to play for at least a corner kick, providing Tomás McDevitt with a close range finish. If that was a simple near range strike, here's the balance. Donegal sprint champion McDevitt with a lovely lofted goal. Cullum Kill suddenly back in at a 3-2. Into the second half, and Ard Kieran keen to avoid the bottom place. That was their fate last year. Niall Kenny definitely knows the way to goal. Now, we've got small pitches in play, so a surprise, maybe we don't see something like this more often. Cullum Kill keeper Dylan McGlynn finding the target. His day job being made ever more difficult by both McKeown and Kenny. McKeown wrapping up his hat-trick for 5-3. And whatever doubt the Sligo and Connacht champions had going into this, finally extinguished by McKeown's fourth. Fergus Campbell with the final word for Cullum Kill, but our Kieran would be champions if Trafrask lost to Clonlisk and by no more than 3 goals.
Chance for them to go ahead. Lovely can finish from Jack Crowley. Just what they need. Crowley has a couple of county medals to his name already. And he has a couple of goals today. 2-0. Brilliant finish again. All going well for the school from the Berne Peninsula. Yeah, they've won it back here. O'Connor inside for Donald O'Sullivan. Lovely back heel, lovely 1-2 as well. Jack Crowley for the hat-trick. It's 3-0. Brilliant from Trafrask. Now Clonlisk could do with the goal back quickly in the second half. It's a good run here by Fionn Kearney. What a goal that is! Brilliant jinking run and a thumping finish as well. Intercepted by Fionn Kearney. He's on his way again. And he's found the net again. Well, the skill from Burke still in here. 3-2 now. And back it goes to Tom O'Connor. That's ambitious. Oh, really good save as well from Kieran Keeshan. Cleared off the line by O'Connor. Good effort that. They go again, James Sampson, lovely skill, brilliant finish. Robert Kearney, at the second time of asking, gets his goal. It is 3-3 here. That breaks for O'Sullivan. Oh, how unlucky for the Bantry Bay Rovers player. Header off the bar. It was Kearney again. And Trafrask can finally celebrate. They've done it. The draw enough for them. What a cracking game it was. 3-3 it finishes. And Trefrask take the title back to Cork.
And Trefrask win the SPAR A Cup.
So Tom O'Connor, congratulations. You've got your hands in the cup. And like Trefrask were in this competition last year as well.
Yeah, it was good achievement. It was hard. It was well fought games. They were tough games.
And how does it feel to get your hand in the cup this year?
Oh, it's good, yeah. It's good. Yeah, well deserved, I think.
Yeah. And Mark Downing, you had a big role to play in this as well, I'm sure.
Yeah.
Talk to us about how you managed to get your hands in the cup today.
Just work for it. Right now.
And like down your neck of the woods, way down in West Cork, obviously means a lot for you to get your hands on a national trophy, the Aviva.
Yeah, it is. It's great to have it.
St. Fintan's from May Glass in Wexford going goals mad in their opening game of the Girls A Cup for small schools. Kira Murphy in great goal scoring form herself, netting 4 for the back-to-back Leinster champions. She'd already been to the Aviva before to play at half-time during an international match. Evelyn Rankin would weigh in with 2. She took part in a soccer sisters training camp at Abbottstown 2 years ago. A brace also coming for Tara Cullen in this one. Jolie Rankin's lone strike would top up St. Fintan's tally to 9 in this first game of the group. Solace for Lissacool on their first trip to Lansdowne came through Ava McGreal's goal. Crushing from Clare back again at the Aviva, and Grace Gleeson in particular in good form, starting out against Donegal's school with a Cashel. Crushing retained their Munster title, having finished 3rd in last year's national finals. Gleeson getting a second here before rounding off an excellent opening match hat-trick for a 3-0 win. If you thought that was impressive, here's the pick of her goals in Crushing's win over Lissacool. Fern Celtic star Gleeson scoring 7 for the North Clare school. For everyone else, it was single strikes in the big win. Anya Sheedy on the mark. Before Tulla United's Sarah O'Donnell added her name to the score sheet as well. And rounding off goals for Manchester United fan Shiva Pennell. And her younger sister Quaylen Pennell, 11-0, the final score. Skullwira Cashel from Fannett in Donegal lost their opening game. St. Fintan's in blue winning theirs and striking first through Evelyn Rankin. The Donegal side drawing level through Emma Nichranahan. Big excitement for their first goal of the competition. That would be added to following good legwork from Rachel Nereal and a lovely finish from Clodagh Nichiron, giving Skullwira Cashel the lead. Into the second half, Nichiron would add her second. Skullwira Cashel growing into their second appearance at the final in the past 3 years. Rachel Nereal making it 4. The 59 pupil school would go 5-1 up after a hopeful long-range strike was parried. Gemma Nikongo pouncing to add another goal. Now here Here's a kickoff and a half. Jolie Rankin with a cracking long-range effort to finish. Skulwira Cashel could still win the Girls A Cup, but they'd need a significant victory over Lissacool to make it happen. Claude Nihilon's four-goal hole would help. Emine Cranachon got a hat-trick for Una Sweeney's side. And Rachel Nereal would net twice for the Donegal School. Olivia Nereal got one too, 10 in total for Skulwira Cashel. Shauna Corrigan, a Connacht handball champion and Roscommon Gaelic footballer, got a consolation for Lissacool.
For the SPAR Girls A Cup, St Fintans have to win by 5, a lesser win, and St Wirra Cashel champions. All crushing need is a draw. Quivin Peril, good throw. Here's Grace Gleeson, always Peril when she's on the ball. She's hit the post. Good break by Avon Rankin for St Fintans. Across and just wide. Big opening for the Wexford side from May Glass. So Grace Gleeson, chance to send this into the opposition half for Crosheen. Good length. She sent it all the way to the net. That is incredible. Crosheen get the opener. Gleeson receiving the throw. Had a pop from a tight angle and it's squirmed in. Well, it's unfortunate for St. Fintans, but it's brilliant for Crosheen. Long throw by Avon Rankin and the header is successful. It's into the net by Kira Murphy. Fintans have one back. Another belting Rankin throw and headed just over the top by Kira Murphy. They are doing some damage on these set pieces. Couldn't get the equaliser there. Absolutely brilliant break by Rankin. Kira Murphy couldn't quite put it away. Tara Cullen's in support here. She's dug it out. Rankin had found her. Kira Murphy again, and Rankin, and a good save by Amy Collar and the crushing captain. Long one by Collar and brilliant long throw. Only she could wrap it up for once and for all for three, and it hasn't gone in, and it's saved by Jenna Ryan. Ryan's throw didn't get far, and it's Grace Gleeson powering through for a hat-trick. What a tournament she's had. Absolutely scintillating. After Grace Gleeson should wrap up the tournament with a hat-trick. And Crosheen have done it. They've won all three games and they have been astounding in this competition. They deserve it all the way through. They've scored 17 goals in total. And they finished top of the pile in what has been a terrific competition for them. The goalkeeping captain, Amy Colleran, gets her hands on the cup. Grace Gleeson, player of the tournament.
I just want to thank the sponsors, SPAR, for the competition and stuff. And all the people who, like, and all the parents and the coaches, Kieran and Joe.
Well done. And Grace, you're player of the tournament as well. You've obviously done a huge amount today.
Yeah, it's great to get it, but it's even better that the team won and that we won.
And like, it means a lot for, you know, a Clare school to win the national title like this.
Yeah, it's brilliant.
It was a high-scoring opener to get the SPAR B Cup underway. Gaelscoil Silvantán from Wicklow up against St Orans of Cockhill in Donegal. And St Orans off to an excellent start. Luke O'Donnell with a clinical drive to put the Ulster champions ahead. 1-0 at half time. The second half would be a lot more open. Brian McQuill taking matters into his own hands to make it 1-1. Cathal McDade then set up O'Donnell for his and St Orans' second. O'Donnell on a hat trick. It wouldn't take much longer for it to arrive. 3-1 to St Orans. Hefty throw from Jack Macklin, opening the door for McQueel again. The Cavantini player with a back header, putting Gaelscoil Kilvonton back into the game, but St Oran's held out. The Snagri National School from Limerick in red against Craigmore from Galway wearing green. The Snagri in the lead through Conor Conlon Ryan. Quick thinking from a set piece, bringing Craigmore level through Dara Kavanagh. And Daniel Fitzmaurice couldn't make progress through a cross. He took it on himself to tee up a shot instead, and it worked. 2-1, Craigmore. An adventurous and open first half continued. Cathal O'Mara's amazing run down the right. He tried to set up Conlon Ryan, and then it came back to O'Mara for the equaliser. We weren't done yet before half-time. Matthew Collins' throw-in touched in by Kavanagh, only to have it chalked off. Sean Costello then hit the post for Lisnagri at the other end. And from that, Craigmore would break rapidly through Igor Sigan. Kavanagh's pullback for Collins, and it was 3-2 Craigmore at half-time. A cracking resumption thanks to Costello's pinpoint free kick. His brother Dara won this competition in 2015. And another set piece would decide it. Collins for Kavanagh, and 4-3 to Connacht champions Craigmore. So how would Lisnagri respond to that, facing St Oran's in the second round of games? The Donegal side going in front through Cathair McDade. An intricate build-up almost providing McDade and St Oran's with a second. That was a chance they may have ended up ruining, especially with Conor Conlon Ryan drawing Lisnagri level. Another tidy finish from him. McDade of the Inishowen Youth Academy making quite a bit happen for his school in this one, turning home another lead goal for them. Oran's 2-1 up at half-time. After the restart, PJ Doherty drew an excellent save out of Lisnagri keeper Anton Donoghue. Luke O'Donnell's good work could have completed that treble for McDade, but his unselfishness would put Derry City player Doherty onto the score sheet himself. And Conor McDade would turn provider for another before the end, converted by Conor McDade for a useful 4-1 win. The fans from Wicklow still buoyant, despite Gaelscoil Kilvonton losing their opener from their own early corner. They were caught out on a very quick Craigmore counter-attack led by Dara Kavanagh. Good composure from him to put the Connacht champions from Clare Galway in front. A rasper from Liam de Burka would bring Kilvonton level. What a strike this was. He's the son of League of Ireland legend Willie. Of Kavanagh's opening goal impressed you. Here he is doing it again, virtually identical to his earlier effort, as Craigmore found themselves back in front. Kilvonton left a little bit open as they tried to push forward for another equaliser. Matthew Collins pouncing for what would be the clincher. The final group game for Gaelscoil Kilvonton and Lisnagri would be decided in the latter's favour. Fifth class student Conor Conlon Ryan starting the move and finishing it as well.
So Luke, we were talking to you earlier on, are you really excited to be here today?
Yep, yes I am.
So you've played two games, tell us what's up next.
The last game is against the Connacht winners, and whoever wins that will lift the trophy.
So you've won your last two games, so this is the clincher now, this next one.
Yeah, it is. So hopefully we get come out on top and win the trophy.
This is it, winner takes all. Corner from Kieran McDade has got a long way back to PJ Doherty. Good try, good save by Duller. Corner was short this time, held up by Luke O'Donnell. And St Oran's are in front in the group decider.
Duller has had a very good tournament. Nathan Duller in the Craigmore goal.
but he's having to face up to a lot here. And it's a tight angle strike from Luke O'Donnell that's gone in his, and St. Oran's second. Luke O'Donnell making everything happen in this decider. And Kieran McDade, it's gone in, and that's a third goal. They are rampant at the moment, and O'Donnell looking for another, and he's been brought down by Igor Sigan. It is a penalty. So far, so good for St. Oran's, and for Luke O'Donnell, who makes it four from the spot. Lovely finish. Taken up by O'Donnell again. He's been terrific. Found by PJ Doherty. And Doherty will get the final touch. It's five for St. Oran's. The cup is surely theirs now. Connor McDade. They have been loving this. McDade wraps it up now. It's six. And St. Oran's take the glory. They take the SPAR B Cup, and they have beaten Craigmore National School of Clare Galway in the group decider by 6-1. A very emphatic triumph in the end. They've played three and they have won three. Craigmore in a very good tournament up to the final game, but it is Oran's who lift the cup. St. Oran's National School of Cockhill Donegal win the SPAR B Cup.
Luke O'Donnell, your player of the tournament, what was your favourite part of the day?
Just getting to play on Ireland's home pitch, the Aviva. It's a great experience too.
And you've got a hat-trick in the final, that must be brilliant.
Yeah, and in the first game too.
And what about you, PJ? You're the captain, you get to bring the trophy home. What was your favourite part of the day?
The experience playing on the Aviva and winning.
Well, what a fantastic day it has been so far, and I'm here with two of the main men of today's event, Colin Donnelly, who is sales director of SPAR, and the man himself, Mick McCarthy. I'm going to talk to the two boys. Tell us what, it has been a record here. Tell us why the SPAR FAI programme is so popular.
It's a brilliant programme. It's a fantastic programme. This is the biggest participation programme within the FAI. 37,000 kids started this programme back in March. That's 1,600 teams in 1,600 schools. So this is absolutely a nationwide event. And there's 24 teams here today to play in this iconic stadium, in a stadium that Mick McCarthy even played when it was called the Lansdowne Road. So this is what dreams are made of. Fantastic day, and SPAR are so proud to be involved in it.
Now, we have a lot of the SPAR retailers here today, and they are the heart of each and every community. What does that mean for them to be watching these young people up and coming in the sports world?
It's about being involved. It's about getting kids involved in sport. And the great thing about here, we've got 42% of the participants in this programme are girls involved in sport. So this is locally based, so it took the 24 teams that made it here today, they had to get through finals, preliminaries, and that's where our local retailers got involved. They actually recruited these schools beside themselves, so within their own locality. So it's absolutely within the community, exactly what SPAR is about.
Thank you, Colin. Now, Mick, amazing to meet you. And for a lot of kids here today as well, it's the very first time in the Aviva Stadium. For them to get the chance to play here, what do you think that means to them?
Colin's just stole all my lines, all them numbers he read off. I'm glad you did that, Colin.
That's okay,
what does it mean to play here? What, to play at the National Stadium? It must be amazing for them. They come and watch their heroes play here. And, of course, some of their heroes are playing now, have been involved in this initiative from the very start and now playing in the team, I believe. I think Seamus was, and a few of the other lads. So for them to think they can go from where we are now, playing on here with the mums and dads and everybody else watching the kids, to actually playing in the national team, how amazing is that?
Do you think it's really important for programmes like this to instill, obviously, inclusivity, but also the opportunity for kids to, you know, work and practice at their art, at their sport? How important is that?
All of that, inclusivity, for sure. As Colin said, there's a record number of girls doing it this year. And I know we keep banging on about that, as if it's strange. It is. It's just getting better and better. The ladies' game is growing. For them to be involved, it's great, I think, one for the fitness, one for the well-being, one for the competitiveness as well. Because there's a competitive edge to it. You know, just playing football on the park and just bring your coats down, and it doesn't really matter. It's lovely to be able to win something. Because at the end of it, that's what we all do it for sport. We do it for enjoyment, yes. But even if you're competing against yourself, you're still competing.
Mick, just tell us now, you know, obviously a man of the world, many years of experience. What advice could you give the young people out there on the pitch today if they are looking to go into a career of professional football?
It's a long time since I was that age. You've just made that point that I'm a man of experience. That you enjoy it first and foremost, and you try your very best, and you listen to the coaches who are giving you advice, because that goes sometimes, you know, in one ear and out of the other, but they're all trying to help. And if you can learn something at one of these events, anything that makes you a better player, then I think that's a success. But really, it is about enjoying it. And if you enjoy it, you're going to play a lot better.
And what do you think about the atmosphere here today?
It's brilliant, isn't it? It's funny when Colin was talking, he got a huge cheer. But it wasn't for you, let me tell you. Like this one, isn't it? Somebody just scored.
Well, thank you so much for talking to us, boys. Enjoy the rest of the day.
Thank you. Pleasure.
Leinster champions Mucklagh from Offaly up against Claren Bridge, Connacht champions for the first time since their second National Spar Cup win in 2010. Nicole Merriman's long-range effort putting Mucklagh in front. Claren Bridge took it on the chin, responding in kind through Alison Graney. A belting start to the second half, but not for the Galway school despite their kickoff. Mucklagh captain Ellen Dolan getting stuck in to crack the Offaly outfit ahead again. The two scorers combining before the end for Merriman to get her second and Mucklagh's third. Glenn Swilly from Donegal against Faha of Kerry. Sarah McGinley spotting the opening to fire Glenn Swilly ahead. And it would get even better for them. McGinley turning provider for Eve McCauley to conjure a splendid finish for 2-0. Faha looking for a route back into the game, and despite the best efforts of Darcy Kelly, finding it through Fiona Bradley. Into the second half, Bradley testing Glenn Swilly keeper Lucy Grant. Easy McGrath finding the target though. It wouldn't be the most acute angle to score from. That would be saved until the end. How did Bradley score from there? It was the final kick of the game, and what a way to win it. Glenn Swilly with an instant chance to bounce back against Mucklagh, but the Leinster champions going in front through skipper Ellen Dolan. A clever corner from Clodagh Power would gift Dolan her and Mucklagh's second. And in the second half, same again. Two games, two wins for Mucklagh. Skulwira Claren Bridge looking to do something similar early on in their encounter with Faha. Isabel White's corner touched in by Siobhan Carr. Carr a constant danger, and Faha finding this out again. The Kerry champions wiping that goal out immediately though from the kickoff, thanks to the accuracy of Ellie Mae Nugent. So this one could go either way. An apt 50-50 battle won by Alison Graney. Decent shot too. In trying to get another one back, Faha now stretched defensively. Carr taking full advantage of that for her hat-trick. Bradley showing a lot of tenacity and getting Sarah Fitzgerald through to score. It's still the first half, by the way. Claren Bridge 4-2 up at half-time, and just one goal in the second half for them. No real surprise that Siobhan Carr would be to the fore again. Faha keeping her at bay with a couple of good saves, the second one not legal though. So a spot kick converted by Carr for her fourth and Claren Bridge's fifth. Faha have won the Kerry title 3 years in a row, breaking through Munster finally this year. Fiona Bradley doing some more breaking of her own, but Claren Bridge winning an 8-goal thriller. So Clarenbridge needing a win in the next game to have a chance of winning the Girls' B Cup. But Darcy Kelly's header putting paid to that. Niece of perennial Donegal International Rally champion Manus Kelly. Darcy making a name of her own.
So McClatt on the front foot here. It's Clodagh Power with the shots. Great recovery by Kate Murphy. Just about kept that one out. Merriman gets it to Dolan. Oh, so unlucky. Off the woodwork. And Dolan has won it back here. Gets it to Merriman. Checks back inside. Decent save again by Murphy. And the corner goes back to Dolan this time. Oh, it's found a way in. Ellen Dolan makes the breakthrough. 1-0 Mukla. She scored in every game in the tournament so far. Oh, decent corner again, and Merriman has headed this one home. Power's delivery. And Merriman did the rest. 2-0 Mukla. Corner for Faha. Oh, almost for Lily Kate Clifford coming in late. Mick McCarthy, the Irish manager, is here, and he's got a touch in this game. So too is Fiona Bradley. Good run, this. Oh, that's a cracking finish. Applause from the Ireland manager, Mick McCarthy, on the sideline. 2-1 now. Yeah, Bradley's been a real standout. She goes again. Great save by Sarah Ryan in the Mukla goal. Here goes Dolan. Twisting and turning and finding the corner. Well, her sister Ava was a star at the finals 3 years ago. Ellen Dolan doing likewise again. And Mukla have done it. 3-2 the final score. The late reply from Bradley, not enough. Mukla win this one by 3-2 to take the title.
So I'm here with the girls' Section B winners from Mukla National School in Offaly, and Ellen Dolan and Sarah Copton. Ellen, congratulations. Tell me all about playing at the Aviva Stadium.
It was great. No one that Shane Long and loads of other great footballers have played here.
And the final, was it a tough game?
Yeah, it was a tough game.
And what was your favourite part of the day?
Scoring goals.
Yeah, how many goals did you score in the tournament?
5.
Oh, that's pretty good. Were you the top scorer on your team? No wonder you got the player of the tournament. Very well done.
St. Joseph's Carrick Macross, the only non-Donegal champions from Ulster this year, and into their stride early through Luke Povell. But Scarborough Banreen equalising through Declan Asagi, who as well as the Aviva is playing at Croke Park this summer after winning the Offaly Gaelic Football Skills Competition. The road Tyrrell denied by 2 saves, the second leading to a penalty kick. Scored by Alandis Yakis, who's on the books of Shamrock Rovers. Right from the kickoff, St. Joseph's getting themselves into bigger trouble. Charlie Connell's shot parried by Dean O'Gorman. Tyrrell gobbling up the rebound. Cavan Monaghan captain and winning the recent Liam Miller Memorial Cup. Povell with a belter to give Carrick Macross some hope, but not enough. Skull Fordric Nafa of Rochestan kicking off. They're now in Cork City as part of the recent boundary change and getting into trouble straight away against Galway's Knock Nakara, who are next door to Salt Hill. Liam Murphy scoring. Many of this team featuring the Knock Nakara FC squad in the Galway League Cup final at Eamon DC Park this same week. Murphy found by keeper Wilfred Mbiaju for the second. So much going through Murphy early on, including this assist for Scott Dillon for 3-0. the Cork side needing to respond and doing so through Owen Kelly. Dillon intercepting a throw to supply Murphy the chance, complete a first half hat-trick for 4-1 at Nakara. Skull Podrick Nafer needing some quick thinking and getting it from Ronan Dooley. A quick cut out by Matthew Kiernan, an excellent low drive, cutting Nakara's lead to 4-3. You might have noticed it is still the first half. Into the second, a nifty footwork from Owen Kelly, allied with a cracking tight-angled finish. Suddenly, it's 4-all. The Galwegians needing some renewed spark up front. Jack Faherty's strike, parried by Ben O'Connell, straight to Dillon, knocked Nakara ahead again. Fodrick Nafer right back up the other end and winning a penalty kick. But Owen Kelly's effort saved by Mbiju. Kelly would quickly make amends from open play though. 5-5. Dillon then matching Murphy's feet in rattling up a hat-trick. Good finish too. Knock Nakara would have the last say. Dillon going for his fourth, but denied by Kiernan. Murphy getting his fourth instead. 7-5. That's entertainment.
All right, boys, from the Scullamore Banrian. Ladies and gentlemen, what does it mean to be here today?
Well, first of all, when you're here, it's kind of loud, but then as soon as you get out here, it's like so quiet.
And this is your first time in the Aviva Stadium, boys.
Yeah. Let's go, eirSport! Let's go! Let's go, eirSport! Let's go!
So, Skull Mura Bonrian on the attack here. It's their captain, Orlando Siakas. It's a great run, it's a thumping finish, and it's 1-0 to the team from Offaly. Siakas lining up the free kick. That's brilliant. The Shamrock Rovers man makes it 2. Goes the number 5, he's slaloming through, he's made it 3! Siakas with the hat-trick, leading by example. Back it goes to the keeper, there's a chance here, and they have one back. Liam Murphy scores for St John the Apostle. Here's Scott Dillon. Oh, what a strike that was, so close. And 200 children from the school here today. They have something to cheer about. They have more to cheer about now. Dillon has squeezed one home and maybe Knock Nakara can pull this one back.
After their 12-goal thriller against Knock Nakara, Skull Fodrick Nafer trying to make amends against St. Joseph's of Carrickmacross, beaten themselves in their opening game. Luke Povell intercepting on halfway, catching the keeper off his line. Ronan Dooley scored in Rochestown's previous 7-5 loss, setting up Ronan O'Shea for the leveller. But Dooley would quickly get on the score sheet himself. He can have that one 2-1. Owen Kelly with a hat-trick in his opening game and going the wide route to avoid the Joseph defence, scoring from an impossible angle. Well, close on it. Skull Fodrick Nafer 3-1 up at half-time and scoring again right after the restart through Dooley. St. Joseph's causing mayhem from a throw to give themselves a sliver of a chance via Gerard Walsh. But any hope they may have had snuffed out by Kelly for his second to make it 5-2. Another long-range belter coming up here from Carrickmacross captain Povell. Dooley completing his hat-trick right before the end. Just the 9-goal thriller this time. So for Knock Nakara to be champions, they would need to win and hope Skull Mura Bonrian lose to Skull Fodrick Nafer and by a margin less than any victory they might achieve themselves against St. Joseph's. Scott Dillon's free kick supplying Liam Murphy for an excellent start. Murphy would finish the game with a hat-trick. This, his second. Dylan's second via deflection would make it 4-0 on the way to a hat-trick himself. Luke Povel's belter from halfway would have earned St. Joseph's some nice respite. Good save from Mbiyoju. Gorgeous skill coming up from Darnell McKinney to get his name up in lights on this one. St. Joseph's will get on the board finally. Povel from the penalty spot, but not Nakara, runaway winners. Skull Fodrick Nafer then only needing a 6-goal win over Skull Mira Banreen to win the Spar Sea Cup. Their opponents requiring just a draw. Ronan Dooley's low effort a tester for Offaly keeper Callum Hurst. The Eton Derry School close to bagging the win to earn them a 100% record. Charlie Connell denied. 0-0 enough then for Skull Mira Banreen to be crowned Spar Sea Cup winners for large primary schools. And a great moment for them as they receive the trophy.
Absolutely fantastic. Yeah, we were just thrilled to get here today and to be All-Ireland champions coming down out of it now. It's we're just on cloud nine with it now. They're a great bunch of lads. Super lads.
Player of the tournament, Declan Asagi. Lot of effort put into that, I bet.
Yeah, it was very hard. The other teams were good, but we just came out on top then.
Tell us about how you managed to get your names on the cup today.
I got one goal. I played well. The home team played well.
It's really hard. We all worked hard and we ended up winning the whole thing. So, like, the last match we could have lost there, but we came on top and won it.
Tell us, you got your teacher and a mummy today.
Absolutely, a very proud teacher and a very proud mummy today for all the girls in Aviva National School. 8 amazing girls that are representing their school and their county. And my daughter Maya is playing today as well with all her friends.
Aviva's National School from Cork red hot early on against Scoligia of Salt Hill, scoring a cracker from Orla Cremin. Margaret Starr then added a brilliant second to make it 2-0 and to put Ovens well in control. Scoligia would get one back through Salt Hill Devon's Zara Brown, but they couldn't force an equaliser. 2-1 the final score.
It's just an amazing achievement to get this far in the competition. We've got 4th, 5th and 6th class here, so we left Galway this morning at 7:45, and they're just so delighted to be in Dublin, being in the Aviva, seeing their buddies playing on such a big occasion. It's great.
St. Lawrence's of Salins, delighted to be here. Scully Sagorn, the defending champions, pushing forward immediately through Jodie Lockray, and that's a superb finish by Lockray. Gaines got a touch and it was enough. Hannah Gaines, 1-1. And the attempt was missed at the clearance. But what a finish by Megan Egan-Brown to put Lawrence's in front. Chance for a long throw by Leah Deegan. And it's hit back with interest by Hannah Gaines. Her second and St. Lawrence's third. It's 3-1. Scully Sagorn need a pick-me-up. Heidi Gill pushing it forward. Lovely skill by the captain, Jodie Lockray. And she's not going to be content until the ball's at the back of the net. And Bunkrana back in it, 3-2. Lockray missed out. Heidi Gill, that's speculative. Oh, it's gone in! Heidi Gill from a long way out, 3-3. Dug out brilliantly by Megan Egan-Byrne. St. Lawrence is in front of the second half. It's a good break for Hannah Gaines. What a finish for her hat-trick. And it's been won back well by Hannah Gaines here, and Gaines winning it back once more, and Megan Egan burns the strike, and it's handled. A penalty kick for St. Lawrence's. Megan Egan Byrne for the hat trick, and it's been saved by Leah Dean. Lockery might come back to it. The scuffed effort, it's in. Will it be enough? It's 5-4 to St. Lawrence's.
Defending champion Skull Isagon looking to turn things around in their next game against Ovens, with the Cork side bidding to maintain their 100% record. Isagon in front through captain Jody Lockery. Kira McGee then got involved to help 2018 winner Heidi Gill provide a brilliant finish for two. Lockery and McGee then combining for the former to score her second and Skull Isagon's third. Ovens desperate to get back into it, and they would. Another superb strike from that girl, Ola Kremen. The Donegal side wrapping it up late through another Buncrana Hearts player, McGee. Both teams now winning one and losing one. Having come through a 9-goal thriller against Skull Isagon, St. Lawrence's took the lead against goalie Skull Ija through a Hannah Gaines header. And the Salon Skull eventually doubled their advantage through a classy finish from Isabel Piao. And before halftime, it would be three. Their side coasting after yet another Salon Celtic player, Lucy Doheny, got her name on the score sheet. More to follow in the second half. KDUL team captain Elise Angland adding another beauty from distance. Donny had wrapped up the scoring in the first half, and she would net again here right before the end, her second and St. Lawrence's fifth goal of the game. Having won one and lost one, Skull Isagon needed a big win in their final group game against Skull Ija, who had lost their first two. Kira McGee's opener was the first of five for her in this one. She also got a hat-trick at last year's finals. Jodie Lockery got three to round off her tournament with 8 goals, and 8 in total for Skull Isagon here, gave them a chance of taking the title.
St. Lawrence's only need a point for overall victory. Ovens have to win by 5 to take the crown. A win by a smaller margin, which sees Skull Isagon retain the title they claimed last year. It's Maeve McGoldrick with a low effort, and it's gone in, it's squeezed in, and Ovens are in front. Doheny with great skill down the left-hand side. Megan Egan, burn, it's in, and Lawrence has equalised. A fine finish by Megan Egan Byrne. Some fans not giving up the ghost just yet. But Ovens are in big trouble again, and the strike from Doheny stopped by Clodagh Fitzgerald. Been a very good goalkeeper in the competition, Fitzgerald. Doheny making a lot happen down the left-hand side. Another save by Fitzgerald. It's a good throw. Back header was troubled by Doheny, and Isabel Pierre has scored the lead goal and maybe the winning goal for St. Lawrence's. Lawrence's finish top of the pile. St. Lawrence's National School from Salons win the SPAR Girls C Cup. 3 out of 3 in the end. They only needed a draw, but they went about it the right way. And Skull Isagon, who lifted the trophy last year, are runners-up. Isabel Pierre with the trophy, and St. Lawrence's are top of the pile.
It's a lot of effort, and I couldn't have done it without my teammates.
And a really good team.
Yeah, we had a great team this year, and hopefully the younger ones will come back next year.
So Mag said St. Lawrence's National School's first national title. Immense amount of work has gone into making this happen, I'm sure.
Oh, it's been amazing. The girls have been super throughout. We got through our Kildare first, and then we went on to the Leinster finals in Port Laois. They beat Offaly, Kilkenny and Laois. And here today, it's amazing. It's an amazing opportunity. It's brilliant. We're delighted.
So it's been another tremendous day here at the Aviva Stadium. And Megan, the SPAR FAI Primary School Fives, they just go from strength to strength.
Yeah, the quality from last year to this year has been tremendous in the improvement. Both girls and boys have come a long way. And so it was a great day out for all.
And I'm sure we've said it before, but the geographical spread is really impressive. I mean, we've had as high up as you can go in the country in Donegal, and actually literally as low down as well in Beira, in Cork.
Yeah, definitely. I think most teams used to be from Dublin, and this year you can see it's come from all over the country, which is great for both girls and boys to show the improvement all over the country.
In terms of women's football, good news that the girls' figures for this competition are well up.
Yeah, they're continuing to rise, and this year there's been 42% of the group has been female, which just shows that the improvement is continuing to be there, and hopefully next year we can take over from the boys' side of things and have that 51-50% ratio. But it's just great for young girls to have the opportunity to play here in the Aviva, in the home of football, and for the boys as well, but especially for the females from my side of things, is to see them opportunities being now given to the girls as well as boys.
There you go then, top marks for all, Sharon.
We've had an electric atmosphere here at the Aviva Stadium for the finals of the SPAR FAI Primary School Fives National Finals 2019. The winners have been crowned and the cups have been received. It really, truly has been an amazing day for our future sporting stars. Look forward to seeing you again here next year.